avoid the eight, to stay out of trouble. Play it right, and your money will double on Cut Sharks. And here's the host of Cut Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Noah. I thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome to Cut Sharks. You're very kind. Thank you. Hey, Gene Wood. Thank you for joining us. I hope you've been with us all week. Thank you. I do hope you've been with us all week because we're in the middle of the first of 3 weeks of very exciting shows with some of America's top game show MCs, and we're turning the tables. They are players rather than MCs, and they're playing for their favorite charity. And we'll get back to it in a moment. First, I want to thank Irene Jaworski of Calaris, Pennsylvania, for the opening poem. And now we're going to open the board and get to the cards. And if you will, Lois and Melinda start loading them in. And we'll meet once again with Martindale and Gene Rayburn.
Mr. Perry, sir.
Hello there.
I must not say the obvious. Naughty, naughty.
Can we avoid this outfit?
Everybody's happy to meet you.
Now, you know, the first thing you learn in show business is never do the obvious joke.
Never do the
obvious. And if you won't do it, I won't do it either.
Right. Don't make fun of the guest clothes.
No,
that's the main
thing. I wouldn't mention...
I got the horse right here.
I wouldn't mention you guys are dolls.
See you guys later. Bye.
Hey,
come on back.
Listen, no, you and I have something coming up in a little while, right?
That's right.
Really?
We made... Oh, you're kidding? We made our movie for TV debut.
For NBC, what?
Coming up the beginning of October here on NBC, The Great American Traffic Jam. We are two of
Co-star,
the guest stars.
We have at least 3 minutes in it.
That's right, yes. Don't blink, because we'll be gone.
You know what I found out about you from that experience? Two things.
What?
First, you are the world's worst golfer.
True.
And secondly, we set back movies at least 20 to 25
the
years.
Very least.
Rude and slow.
Have you ever done a movie, Gene? Have you ever done a movie?
Yes. I did a movie with Jack Lemmon, Doris Day, a long time ago.
Pillow Talk.
Yes.
Oh, you knew that?
No, it wasn't Pillow Talk. It was called It Happened to Jane.
See, you almost forgot the title of the movie. Big movie.
And it's a funny thing. Gary Moore and Dave Garraway and Bill Cullen and everybody was in it. And I went to shoot my scene, and I said, and I didn't like the scene. And I said to the unit manager, don't put my name on this thing. And I got my money, and they paid me, and a year later, it came to our little town where we were living outside of New York at that time, and I went to see it with my wife, and there it was. Dave Garraway, Bill Cullen, Gary Moore, I mean, everybody. And my name was in it. Well, they were all on camera for about 3 seconds, so there's Gary Moore. I had a nice 4-minute scene with Jack Lemmon. I was charming, cute, and funny, and my name was not in it.
That'll teach you to keep your mouth shut there.
Yeah. That was his last movie, by the way. That was it.
Wink is playing for the West Tennessee Cerebral Palsy Center. Gene is playing for Planned Parenthood. And we'll pick up where we left off. Play the best 2 out of 3. Game 1 went to Wink. And now looking at the board in game 2, Wink has already moved over with a 10 as his base card. Now he needs 2 cards. Gene, better base card to Jack, but he needs 4 cards. We pick up with a question. Question 3, and it goes to you, Gene. Gene, we asked 100 women, have you ever burst into tears but not known why you were crying? How many women have burst into tears without knowing why?
How old were they?
About your age.
Just 100 women, about your age, okay.
Young women.
That's right.
How many women would do that? Oh, I would say quite a bit.
Yeah?
63.
63 out of 100 have burst into tears without knowing why. Higher or lower, Wink?
Wow.
He made you think there with that number, huh?
We don't know how old they were.
No? Women?
Just,
cross-section?
Just young women, huh?
Talk to her. Ask her.
63? She wouldn't know. She's too young. Burst into tears without knowing why. I think it's going to be... a little higher than 60.
A little higher than that?
Yeah. I think that happens to all of them at one time or other.
Now we'll talk to her. Now that it doesn't influence your answer at all, Lois, have you ever burst into tears without knowing why? Never, says Lois.
Can I change my...
No, it's all locked in now. 63 and higher. The actual number of women who have burst into tears without knowing why is 71. It is higher. You got it, Wink. And you got a 10.
No, you weren't. All right, I got a 10, right?
You can play it or change it.
I'm going to change it. Change the 10.
Kind of a borderline card. Can he improve it? A 6. It is a little better.
Oh, wow.
Lower!
with a six.
Lower.
With a six, I got to go higher.
Yeah. But Gene said lower. He says higher. And it's
yeah.
King.
All right.
You got it.
Okay, lower.
If this is lower, Wink goes for the big money.
Yeah.
Said he was going to go the other. What's that?
There's no doubt about it. Watching Gene play the game for the past couple of days, when he said higher, I knew I had to go lower. There was no doubt in my mind.
Gene, you'll be back to play a little bit later. You got $300 so far for your charity.
Okay.
Your charity. See you later, Gene. Wait, come on out here with me. Now, you haven't had a crack over there at the big money yet.
Dude, this will be it. This is my first time.
Well, you've got $200 now for your charity, and now we're not even going to make you wait. We are going to go for the big money right now.
I don't even have time to think about it.
Don't even have time to think about it. We're going to do it right now. As soon as that podium stops, let's get over and go for that big money. Come on. A little known charity, the West Tennessee Cerebral Palsy Association.
Yeah, they have a little CP center back there, and I do a telethon back there. In fact, they put my name on it this next year, the Wink Martindale Cerebral Palsy Telethon.
That's
and
nice.
It's for a little center there. They started in a little dollhouse behind another house a few years ago, and with one person, one doctor, and now they have they're serving over 40 kids, and they have about 7 people on the staff. So it's small, but it's growing.
All right, that's nice. That's nice to hear. You cut those money cards before we run on the air, right?
Yes.
Let's do it. Here's $200. Remember, you can change that base card at each level, Wink, as we start off with 200 and a 2.
Oh, we got to go up.
How much?
All right, let's see. $150.
$150 higher than a 2.
Yes.
With a 7. $350, and now near the middle.
$300 higher.
$300?
$300 higher.
Now, I really feel, I have no idea, but Wink, the middle card is the 8. You are right near that middle card with the 7. You can do what you want, but you're taking a big chance if you go
with $300. Okay, I tell you what. Let's make it $50, because you're right. I'm going to take some advice.
Okay.
That's okay.
It's
I won't
up to you.
Hold it again.
I don't want to talk you into something, but I just want to make you aware of the odds.
I understand. Right. $50
higher. $50 higher.
Yeah.
It is higher with the 8. Now you are in the middle.
That is a tough card. Can I change that 8?
No.
let's see. What should I do, audience, huh? Okay, let's go $50 higher.
We haven't seen a high one yet.
$50
higher.
Sounds
like a good choice for the middle bet.
Oh.
That's not a bad trade. $50 for a deuce. I'll take it any day in the week because we're going to give you another $250. There's the second two. There are only two more out.
I'm going to go $500 higher.
$500 higher than a 2. Yes,
yes.
To the 7.
All right.
Up over the 1,000 mark now.
Okay,
be careful. Back
to the middle. Let's make it $50 higher. $50
higher. $50 higher than a 7. A
yeah.
10 is good enough.
Right. Got a roll going. Let's make it... all right, let's go with $500 lower. $500 lower.
You're taking a chance. I hope you're right. $500 lower than a 10? No. Taking a chance, but nonetheless, a great card moves up. You have 600 and a king.
Okay. I'm going to go $600. Oh, I'm going to go all the way lower.
You're going to go
all the way lower.
Double the West
Tennessee CP Center.
$1,200 for the CP Center if this is lower. No. Now I'm going to tell you something. Wait a minute. Right now, doggone it, you are not going to bust with that CP Center. That's much too important. I'm going to tell you, you've got $200 now. I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to tell everybody else, there is no way that any one of you playing here is going to go away with less than $5,000 for your charity. That's for sure.
That's super.
We'll be right back, right after this. We are back. And now, as Lois deals out two brand new decks of cards, we welcome back Alan Ludden and Bill Cullen with us.
Alan has
$100 so far.
I have $100 so far.
$100.
But Mike, but the zoo has 5,000 in any case.
That's right.
No matter how badly I do.
We were holding that back, but doggone it, the cars have been a little slow.
Yeah.
Absolutely. No one's going to go away for their charity with less than 5,000.
So we got 5,000 for the
bus. You guys are nice enough to come out here and play for your favorite charity. Well, gol darn it,
well,
your
fun.
Favorite
it's
charity.
Fun. I want to see your teeth.
What do you mean, my teeth?
Bill?
Yeah.
What? Did you know, when Wink Martindale and Jim Perry were out here on camera with those teeth, it almost broke the cameras. Ever seen so many teeth?
We counted. There were 78 between them.
Between them, yeah, exactly. All pearly white.
Someone's hey, listen, lower. Talking about money. This man over here needs no help at all. Bill Cullen already has $6,100 for his
good
charity.
For me.
Which is the Salvation Army. Good players.
6,000 to 100.
Yeah.
Well,
let's continue
let's
the round
go.
Robin.
I'm
let's
win
go.
Now.
All right. Alan is ready. I'm sure Bill is ready. And the best two out of three starts with a question to Alan. We found 100 divorced men who are still paying alimony to their ex-wife. And we asked them, have you ever sent your ex-wife an alimony check that bounced? How many men have sent an alimony check that bounced? 100, says a lady who obviously got one that bounced, I'm sure.
I think perhaps some guys have done it on purpose, and a lot of guys maybe have done it accidentally. But I would say probably over 50%. Let's say 55.
55 out of 100 in this case have sent a check that bounced. Bill?
That's pretty high number. But going along on the same premise, I would say slightly higher.
Even higher than that?
Yep. Yeah, higher. Yeah.
Well, the actual number of men who have sent an alimony check that bounced is 8. If I'm not mistaken,
yeah.
The reason that would be low is I think they send you to jail if you don't send those checks.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I do believe that
well,
will
Bill
get one to send the check.
No, we don't know about
and
that.
Alan starts off the match with a
that's
4.
A good card.
That's a good card.
Good card, Alan.
Good
card,
good
card. Look, I've only got 100 down here, but I'll go higher.
Higher he says. It
yeah.
Is a
okay. Lower. Lower.
You're going to play it lower?
Yes,
yay,
sir.
Go.
Okay. Freeze.
And we move over to the freeze bar. Alan playing very conservative there, not taking Bill's advice. Can't say I blame you, Alan.
That's right.
Bill,
mm-hmm.
We asked 100 professional striptease dancers.
Oh, you've come to the right place.
Professional striptease dancers. Uh-huh. Would you pay to see a male stripper perform? How many women strippers would pay to see a male stripper?
Well, I most of them would get in off the on the cuff.
I was going to say
professional
pay.
Courtesy.
Yeah. Well, courtesy, yes.
But female strippers would pay because they're sports. They are sports. They're big livers.
How do you know?
And that's not all it's big either. I would say 65.
65 out of 100 would pay to see a male stripper, Alan.
Well, they're sports.
They're sports.
They're sports. Therefore, they don't have to pay.
Uh-huh.
I would say lower.
You say lower. I don't consider them sports. I consider them athletes. You know, one thing twirling one way and one twirling the other, that's definitely an athlete.
That takes a lot
65,
of money.
You got to think about that. 65 and lower. The actual number of women strippers who would pay to see a male stripper is 47. Alan is right. It is lower. Alan, you've got a 6.
You're rooting for me. Isn't he nice? He's going
go.
For the underdog. All right. Change that card.
And winning the question, you can change it. A jack is a good change.
Higher.
It's a brand new deck, isn't it?
Brand new deck.
Deck,
right.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes,
ooh.
A 2.
Higher.
Oh, for the first game of the match.
Okay.
Alan Lovin wins game number 1. And as Alan tries to make a comeback for the Greater L.A. Zoo Association, we'll be right back.
He
and Lois deals out same two decks of cards, and this time it is the same cards off the top of the deck. So if you can remember what's been played, it is often a help. Game 1 went to Alan, and we'll start game 2 with a question to you, Alan. Alan, we asked 100 child psychiatrists. Generally speaking, should a mother worry if she finds her 8-year-old son playing with her makeup? How many child psychiatrists?
I was going to finish that, and it wasn't going to be makeup.
How many child psychiatrists said a mother should worry if her young son plays with her makeup?
I don't think psychologists would say that many should. I don't think you should worry. But psychologists are not always.
These are psychiatrists.
Psychiatrists.
They're
well,
worse.
They're worse.
Yeah.
I would say those crazy guys probably said, Oh, I don't think they would say. I think it would be about 30.
30 out of 100 say you should worry if son is playing with a makeup.
I would say lower.
I would
even
think
lower
so.
Than that.
Lower,
yeah.
Yes.
I wish I hadn't said 30.
I figure it's. I think you both think it's kind of natural curiosity.
Yeah. Yeah.
30 and lower. The actual number of child psychiatrists who said a mother should worry if her young son plays with her makeup is 35.
Not lower, a little bit higher. A relatively low number, but Alan
well,
has it a little higher than the 30.
Yeah.
And Alan has a 6.
I want to change that.
Okay. He asked so sweetly. A 3. Good
oh,
change.
Good. Good card.
Higher than a 3. A 5.
I haven't had a chance.
Higher. Higher than a 5. A queen. Lower.
Lower than a queen.
A 3.
Higher.
Trying to tie up the match.
Yes. Yay.
Alan takes the ball over and ties things up. So, my goodness. Alan Ludden was hot as a firecracker there, winning 2 in a row.
It is about time.
Bill, we're going to see you a little bit later.
Thanks a lot.
But listen, $6,100 already for the Salvation Army.
Take
just
care of my deck.
All right, Bill.
You can use my deck.
Come on down here.
We're going to be right back with the money cards with Alan for the Greater L.A. Zoo Association right after this. Back with Alan Ludden, talking about the Greater L.A. Zoo. That's a very worthwhile charity.
You know, may I just say one thing about the Los Angeles Zoo? It is one of the best zoos in the whole world.
It really is.
And it's getting better every year. Betty's on the board of directors. And if you're coming to Los Angeles, or you live in Los Angeles, you should go to the zoo. There's a lot of publicity given to the zoo, to the San Diego Zoo. Well, rightfully so.
Oh, yeah.
But the Los Angeles Zoo is a remarkable zoo. It's beautiful. But they need new buses, and so that's what we're playing.
Okay. Well, we've dealt out the cards. Since we already played the money cards once and explained the rules for any new viewers, we dealt them out in front of our studio audience after you cut them, and let's go make some money for the zoo right now.
Let's do it.
$200. Come on. And remember, you can change that base card, Alan, if you need to, starting with an ace. All right.
Now, there are 3 other aces in there, right?
That's the only thing that can hurt you, the 3 other aces.
Save 50. I'll go for 150 lower.
$150 lower. Yes, and a king is a good card.
I'll go for 300 lower.
300 lower than the king. Yes, a jack. Be careful with that one. That one.
All right. Okay. I'll say 50 and go 600 lower.
That one always scares me. I hope he's right. 600 lower. Yes.
All right.
Okay. Got by that one, and we're going to give you another 200 when we move it up. Do you want the 10?
Can I change it?
You can indeed.
Well, I don't have that much. 10 isn't that bad. I could get a 6.
It's not that wonderful either.
What?
It really is not a wonderful card, I must say.
Well, all right. Now watch me get an 8. I'm going to listen to your friends, Gene.
You're going to change it?
Yeah.
If you got an 8, at least you'd stay with the $50 bet, and you might get a better one here. I think it's a pretty good change. Let's see if it works out.
Okay.
Come on. He's changing it. Well, after we had this long discussion, he's playing a 10.
You know, that's kind of the story of my life. Lower.
And how much?
I'm going to go 500 lower.
$500 lower.
Yes! 1950 and a 9. You're scaring me, but you're doing well.
$500 lower.
Now that is right next to the middle card, the 8.
I know, but they've got a lot of high cards up here.
All right, we haven't seen them all. You're sure you want to go $500 lower?
I want to go $500 lower. Yeah.
$500 lower than a 9?
Yes! $2450
and a 6.
Now. We'll go 50. No, I'm going to go. I'm going to go 300 higher.
$300 higher than a 6.
No.
This one has failed you, and now we're going to move up to 5, and you're in an interesting position. Do you want
that
change
it?
You can change it.
I want to change it.
All right. Big change. He's got 2150, and the 5 becomes. Oh, up the middle with an 8. You must bet at least 1,075, Alan. What's your big bet? You're in the middle.
You're right. Lower. Yeah, lower. I want to go because I want that money bad.
How much?
I'm going to go lower. I'm going to go lower, and I'm going to go 2,000 lower.
$2,000 lower than an 8. He's right!
Real.
Fake.
None of their business.
All new Three's a Crowd. Find out who knows you best. Weeknights at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. I'm Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
It's kind of natural curiosity.